Hi everyone, welcome to my channel Lipstick Amour. My name is Jyoti. Today I'm going to be talking about my October favorites. I know it is super late, it's already mid-November, but I feel like it's important to talk about your favorites because I love watching videos from other people who talk about their favorites because you know that if it's your favorite, then it must be good. Let's get into it. So October was Halloween, so I definitely got some Halloween makeup, and my most favorite of all the releases out there for Halloween was the ColourPop's Hocus Pocus collection. And I truly, truly enjoyed this palette. I know some people did not like it. They were like, oh, it is the same as the Garden Variety palette. It's the same shades that we've seen before. And they tried to recreate the palette, but as a newbie to ColourPop and not having their palettes before, this was something that I really, really enjoyed. The packaging was nice, the shades was nice, and everything in this collection was absolutely stunning. They had these three lipsticks in the collection, very creamy, beautifully applied on the lips, and three different shades of red. I did get introduced to their lippy pencils as well through this collection, and I really like them too. But you do have to sharpen them with a sharpener. They are not the retractable kinds. They are the type that you have to sharpen them. And the gel liners were absolutely beautiful. Some really nice shades, green, orange, like rust colors and purples. I feel like the whole entire collection was just wonderful and I enjoyed it so much. Talking about ColourPop, I also enjoyed their That's So Taupe palette. I felt like this was such a nice cool tone palette. These are shades that I don't really reach out to. I normally reach out to more colorful and warmer shades, so this was a great way for me to get introduced to cooler tones, and I feel like the look that I created with this came out really beautiful. There are a lot of shimmer shades in here, so I do feel like that you can use this for the holidays if you are more of a cool tones shades type of person. I do have videos on both this That's So Taupe palette and also the Hocus Pocus collection if you're curious about them, but these are the two that I really enjoyed from ColourPop. Then there's something from Soul Body that actually came out in the summertime that I have been using a lot lately. This is their Soul Body. It's like a bronzer that you could also use for your body. Now, it's called Face and Body Bronzing Balm, but I've only used it on my face. I am new to bronzers, so I was a little intimidated, but actually, this cream bronzer, this is what it looks like on the inside. It's very natural. Like when I apply it on my cheeks, it just comes out really natural, and it is easy to apply. So this might be a good bronzer for beginners. Besides ColourPop, I have also been enjoying Milani a lot lately. I'm not sure if these were in any of my previous favorites videos, but I've really been loving this Milani's highly rated mascara. And I do believe it might have won some sort of award. And it is quite nice. I love the packaging with the black and the gold stars on it. And it also is a really nicely buildable mascara. So you could do a few swipes, call it a day for a daytime look, but if you want to go more dramatic, you can really nicely build it up. And it's just a perfect product, an affordable one that is a good product, but it's also nice packaging. And then Milani's Conceal and Perfect Concealer. I have been using this so much because it is that nice. I've used e.l.f.'s Camo Concealer, their regular one, not the hydrating one. I've used CoverGirl's Concealer. I've used Dose of Colors. And I recently used Shape Tape from my Ipsy bag. From all of the concealers that I've tried so far, I do have to say that this one is the best one, at least for me, the way it's worked out for my eye area. It is very creamy. It is not too thick though. So it feels a little bit liquidy when you apply it compared to some of the other concealers, but once you blend it all in, it gives good coverage. So it feels light, but it provides full coverage. Now it does smell like paint, that's the only downside, but when it comes to how it looks on your eyes. It is a good full coverage concealer. In October, I also came upon this LA Colors Lip Oil. I really love this lip oil. It comes with like different scents. It is completely clear, even though you can see that there's color in the bottle, but it's actually completely clear. But it's pretty and it has this beautiful bubbly effect. I do want to bring it to you again. You can see those little bubbles in there and this gold cap and the gold letters. It's just it's so beautiful. It smells good. There are many different scents, like maybe 5 or 6 different scents, and it applies beautifully on your lips. It's not sticky, but it's just a nice lip oil. The wand was a bit stiff, so applying it can be a little bit hard, but overall I still really enjoy this product. And the last thing that I really liked is this Ciate London Editorial Palette. It's just something about this palette that I really, really like. It's the container is plastic, which is very different from the palettes that I normally have, which are made of cardboard. And it just has a very classic feeling. There is a mirror in here, and the shades are just so unique, so beautiful. I'm not sure if I got it in my last BoxyCharm or it might have been the one before, but I don't believe I've ever spoken about this in my favorites. I just fell in love with the shades in here and the packaging of this palette. So that's it for my October faves. It wasn't a long list, but I really, really did enjoy all of these products, and there are so many new ones that I'm discovering in November. So hopefully when I do my November video, it's not too late into December. I will try to do it a little bit earlier. Thank you so much for watching. And if you like these type of videos where I talk about my favorites, let me know in the comments down below. And also don't forget to subscribe. Thank you. Bye. Thank you so much for watching.